Hello everyone, this is Rajamanikam Antony Muthu from QPT. A detailed study of magnets built by MIT and Commonwealth Fusion Systems confirms that they meet requirements for an economic compact fusion power plant. In the pre-dawn hours of September 5, 2021, engineers achieved a major milestone in the labs of MIT's Plasma Science and Fusion Center, PSFC, when a new type of magnet made from high-temperature superconducting material achieved a world record magnetic field strength of 20 tesla for a large-scale magnet. That is the intensity needed to build a fusion power plant that is expected to produce a net output of power and potentially usher in an era of virtually limitless power production. The test was immediately declared a success, having met all the criteria established for the design of the new fusion device dubbed Spark, for which the magnets are the key enabling technology. The team celebrated their accomplishment. But that was far from the end of the process. Over the ensuing months, the team tore apart and inspected the components of the magnet, pored over and analyzed the data from hundreds of instruments that recorded details of the test, and performed two additional test runs on the same magnet, ultimately pushing it to its breaking point in order to learn the details of any possible failure modes. All of this work has now culminated in a detailed report by researchers at PSFC and MIT spin-out company Commonwealth Fusion Systems CFS, published in a collection of 6 peer-reviewed papers in a special edition of the March issue of IEEE Transactions on Applied Superconductivity. Together, the papers describe the design and fabrication of the magnet and the diagnostic equipment needed to evaluate its performance, as well as the lessons learned from the process. Overall, the team found the predictions and the computer modeling were spot on, verifying that the magnet's unique design elements could serve as the foundation for a fusion power plant. The successful test of the magnet was the most important thing in the last 30 years of fusion research. Before the September 5th demonstration, the best available superconducting magnets were powerful enough to potentially achieve fusion energy, but only at sizes and costs that could never be practical or economically viable. Then, when the test showed the practicality of such a strong magnet at a greatly reduced size, overnight it basically changed the cost per watt of a fusion reactor by a factor of almost 40 in one day. Tokamaks, the most widely used design for experimental fusion devices, have a chance of being economical. The comprehensive data and analysis from the PSFC's magnet test, as detailed in the 6 new papers, has demonstrated that plans for a new generation of fusion devices, the one designed by MIT and CFS, as well as similar designs by other commercial fusion companies, are built on a solid foundation in science. Fusion, the process of combining light atoms to form heavier ones, powers the sun and stars. But harnessing that process on Earth has proved to be a daunting challenge, with decades of hard work and many billions of dollars spent on experimental devices. The long-sought but never yet achieved goal is to build a fusion power plant that produces more energy than it consumes. Such a power plant could produce electricity without emitting greenhouse gases during operation and generating very little radioactive waste. Fusion's fuel, a form of hydrogen that can be derived from seawater, is virtually limitless. But to make it work requires compressing the fuel at extraordinarily high temperatures and pressures. And since no known material could withstand such temperatures, the fuel must be held in place by extremely powerful magnetic fields. Producing such strong fields requires superconducting magnets. But all previous fusion magnets have been made with a superconducting material that requires very cold temperatures of about 4 degrees above absolute zero, that is 4 kelvins or minus 270 degrees Celsius. In the last few years, a newer material nicknamed REBCO for rare earth barium copper oxide was added to fusion magnets and allows them to operate at 20 kelvins, a temperature that despite being only 16 kelvins warmer, brings significant advantages in terms of material properties and practical engineering. Taking advantage of this new higher temperature superconducting material was not just a matter of substituting it in existing magnet designs. Instead, it was a rework from the ground up of almost all the principles to build superconducting magnets. The new Revco material is extraordinarily different than the previous generation of superconductors. The new papers in Transactions on Applied Superconductivity describe the details of that redesign process now that patent protection is in places. One of the dramatic innovations, which had many others in the field skeptical of its chances of success, was the elimination of insulation around the thin flat ribbons of superconducting tape that formed the magnet. Like virtually all electrical wires, conventional superconducting magnets are fully protected by insulating material to prevent short circuits between the wires. But in the new magnet, the tape was left completely bare. The engineers relied on Repco's much greater conductivity to keep the current flowing through the material. The initial tests described in previous papers proved that the design and manufacturing process not only worked, but was highly stable, something that some researchers had doubted. The next two test runs, also performed in late 2021, then pushed the device to the limit by deliberately creating unstable conditions, including a complete shutoff of incoming power that can lead to a catastrophic overheating. Known as quenching, this is considered a worst-case scenario for the operation of such magnets, with the potential to destroy the equipment. Part of the mission of the test program to actually go off and intensely quench a full-scale magnet so that the researchers can get the critical data at the right scale and the right conditions to advance the science, to validate the design codes and then to take the magnet apart and see what went wrong, why did it go wrong, and how do they take the next iteration toward fixing that. That final test, which ended with the melting of one corner of one of the 16 pancakes, produced a wealth of new information. For one thing, they had been using several different computational models to design and predict the performance of various aspects of the magnet's performance, and for the most part, the models agreed in their overall predictions and were well validated by the series of tests and real-world measurements. But in predicting the effect of the quench, the model predictions diverged, so it was necessary to get the experimental data to evaluate the model's validity. The researcher emphasizes that a major reason the team was able to accomplish such a radical new record-setting magnet design and get it right the very first time and on a breakneck schedule was thanks to the deep level of knowledge, expertise, and equipment accumulated over decades of operation of the Alcatraz CMOD tokamak, the Francis Bitter Magnet Laboratory, and other work carried out at PSFC. Thanks for watching this video. Now you can get my ebooks freely at www.rajamanikam.com by using the discount code QPT100. Use this offer before it ends. Contact me if you are interested to earn a 50% commission for selling my ebooks. Thanks.